Good morning, dear children. Once again, I am here with poem Rain on the Roof, written by Coates Kinley. Yesterday, we have seen the summary of this poem and about the author. Now, today, we will go to complete explanation, detailed explanation of this poem. Stanza 1, let me read once for you, then one by one line we will take and I will explain you here. Now you also open your textbook before you, keep your textbook before you, listen the words and see in the textbook what I am reading. So here the stanza 1. When the humid shadows over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Now the second stanza. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy beams start, and a thousand recollections with the air threads into woof as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. Now in memory comes my mother as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers in. She left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. Coates Kinley. Very beautiful poem written by Coates Kinley. Now, one by one, we'll see the explanation. I have written the new words, whichever I feel that, you know, this is a new word for this class, so I have written here. But if you also feel when you read this, you underline the words and write down the meaning. Means next time, whenever you will read this poem, it is very easy to understand the complete meaning of that poem. So here, the humid shadows means cloud. Hove means hanging upon. Starry spheres means star, and melancholy means it's a sadness, unhappiness, bliss, joy. So we go to the first stanza, that is, when the humid shadows over all the starry spheres, all the humid shadow clouds, you know, the stars are disappeared, stars are not there on the in the cloud by being covered by clouds, so stars are not there in the sky, and the melancholy darkness gently beams in rainy tears. I don't know why the poet is feeling very sad, and he is telling that when it is raining and that rain, melancholy sadness, it's coming the tears from the eyes. It's feeling him very sad. What means he thinks that the rain, it is raining and the dark cloud is there, so as if the tears are coming from the, you know, from his eyes or from human beings. What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed. But even though it's a sad, you know, sad everywhere, but I feel very happy to be in my room and in my cozy bed, to press the pillow, because outside it's raining, but I'm in my room, in my cozy bed, I'm feeling very Good. And now I'm listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Sitting inside the room in the bed, soft bed, listening that pitter patter sound which is coming on the roof, it makes me very happy. You know, dear children, yesterday we have seen that because in the summary, this rain on the roof, this rain brings in his life very happiness. And we have seen yesterday that he went in the past, in his childhood. And when he thinks about his childhood, when it was raining, that he feels very happiness. This is a complete poem is that. This is in the first stanza. What is the second stanza saying? Every tinkle on the shingle has an echo in the heart. Every tinkle on the, what is the tinkle means what? The tinkle means ringing sound. Whichever means each and every roof, that roof, rectangular type of roofs are there in our home, and on each and every roof, when the it is raining on the falling, that raindrops on that sound feels me very. See, every tingle on the shingles has an echo in the heart. Feeling that sound, feeling me very, very happy. And the thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. You know, when he is there in the bed, he is listening that sound, and when he was listening, the thousands of fancies, the dreams is coming in my mind. You know, he's thinking, as I said, the past. So the all the things in the that describes how the raindrops make a tinkling sound as they fall on the shingles on the roof. Each sound made by the rain is repeated in the next instant by the beating his heart. What he has only been ignoring till now starts that whatever he was ignoring before, but now with the help of this sound, he went in his dream. And a thousand dreamy fancies into being start. मेरे दिमाग में पुराने जो बचपन के जो मेरी यादें थी बारिश की, वो सारे क्या होने लगी है, आने लगी है. And a thousand recollection with your air threads into wool thread. What is there? Recollection, memories, air threads, dreaming memories. इतने सारे memories, so many memories, the childhood memories are there. Now when I heard the pitter patter sound, it comes in my mind and it was a weaving. बुनना चालू हो गया, एक दूसरे से attached हो गए, पूरे एक सारे collection comes in my memory. So with their air threads into wool. As I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof, as I am listening, all the recollection comes in my mind, and it is varying each other, and it gives me very happiness. The poet describes this in this second stanza. The last stanza, what is that in the last stanza? Now in memory comes my mother. In my mother, now in memory comes my mother. In my childhood, now that memory has come, my mother's memory. When I was very child, when I was very small, my mother, what mother? As she used in years ago. What it is saying, telling that? That he can actually identify the patchwork, you know, the patchwork of his memory. He remembers that during his childhood, his mother used to look at him and his siblings, brothers and sisters. She used to look there, you know, brothers and sister. That comes in his mind. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone, to regard the darling dreamers. She left them till the dawn. What is mean by this, you know? Before. She, when the children, this all the brothers and sisters used to sleep, her mother used to come and she used to say very carefully, and she thinks that not till morning, till dawn, I cannot see them. So with affection, with love, she used to see them. Oh, I see her fond look on me. ही रिमेम्बर्स दैट, कितने प्यार से वो हमको क्या करती थी, देखा करती थी. एज आई लिस्ट हिज रिफ्रेन, एज आई एम लिसनिंग, LIST, मिस लिसन, लिसन टू द रिफ्रेन, रिफ्रेन द म्यूजिक, म्यूजिक यू नो दैट द साउंड. देन शी न्यू शी वुड नॉट सी हिम देन अगेन टिल द नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग. हिज मदर वुड बेंड डाउन एंड वॉच ओवर हिम इन अ पर्टिकुलर. These memories are evoked, you know, especially the mother's memories evoked as they listen, as he listens to the repetitive sound, rhythm, all raindrops which was falling on his roof. So here the complete story about his memories he has written by Coates Kelly, has written his all the past memory in this poem, that is Rain on the Roof. Dear children, now what is then what we see after the poem? Yes, you are correct, the rhyming scheme of the poem, and after that the figure of speech as we have learned. So can you see the here I am reading here, when the humid, so last words I will write, means here, no, I cannot write it on the blackboard. Here I will write the last words of each stanza, means you will come to know the rhyming scheme of that poem. See what is here, when the humid shadows over, H-O-V-E-R, over, and the over all the starry spheres, S-P-H-E-R-E-S, spheres, and the melancholy darkness, darkness, D-A-R-K-N-E-S-S, darkness, gently weeps in the rainy tears, T-E-A-R-S, tears. And what is that? What the bliss to press the pillow, P-R-L-L-O-W, P-R-L-L-O-W, pillow. Of a cottage chamber bed, B-E-D, bed. What is the second last line of the first stanza? And now listening to the patter, patter, P-A-T-T-E-R, patter, on the soft rain overhead. The last line of the first stanza, overhead. O-V-E-R-O-V-H-E-A-D. These are the last words of the first stanza. So what will become the rhyming scheme of this? Can you tell me? What is the rhyming scheme? Okay. Over means what will be there? A, B, C, B, then D, E, I think so here. What is there? A, B, C, D, E, F. I think so. E. Pay attention here, dear children. Rhyming scheme, you know. Rhyming scheme is A, B, C, B, D, E, F, C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are the rhyming scheme. And if you go to the second stanza and the third stanza also, you will see the same rhyming scheme in the first, second paragraph and the third paragraph. So complete poem is rhyming scheme is this only. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That A, B, C, B, B, E, F, D, E, F, E. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A, B, C, B, D, E, D, E, F, E. These are the rhyming scheme. This rhyming scheme will continue in the second paragraph also and the third stanza also. The one more thing is that poetic device, that is figure of speech. Hardly 2-3 figure of speech will take, that is it. Okay, what is the alliteration? What is in the first stanza? First stanza is, we can see there, the See the first stanza, third and fourth line. First stanza, third and fourth line is what is it there? And the melancholy dark maid gently weeps in the form of rainy tears. That is a personification. What is the definition of personification? Personification is yes. That we can show that the personification gives the animal's bird look like a feeling, like a non-living things into living things. That is a personification. Non-living things into a living things. That is a personification. Non-living thing into the, what is your clouds, melancholy clouds comes in the tear, that it is showing there. What is that? Just see the metaphor. Where is the metaphor? In the stanza 1, the line 1. When the humid shadows over, the word shadows actually means the clouds. That is the metaphor. What is the definition of metaphor? Carrying over two different objects become one. That is a metaphor. So that is in the first stanza, and in the first stanza, the first line, when the humid shadows over, the word shadow actually means the cloud. And one more, the alliteration will say here, 2-3 figure of speeches are there, dear children. But the last we'll see that you can find out, open your figure of speech notebook, that there you will find one more that is a very easy, that will say that alliteration. What is the definition of alliteration? Repetition of a consonant. So what is that definition? Stanza 1, the line 1. When the humid shadows over, H and H, H-U-M-I-D, humid. And over, H-O-V-E-R, over C, the repeated consonant. Repeated letter is, that is called alliteration. So, repetition of initial consonant sound in the same line. When the humid shadows over, humid and over have the similar first syllable, that is the consonant. So, here we are completing our poem, that is Rain on the Roof. Dear children, I hope you have understood this poem. Thank you and have a nice day.